There are more than 70 mammal species in Marin County. In this tutorial, you'll learn how to identify the ones known to be detected by camera traps so far. Our camera traps do best taking photos of land mammals the size of a chipmunk or bigger. They are not so great at telling us about tiny mammals like mice, or flying mammals like bats, or marine mammals like whales. The cameras also capture images of birds, reptiles, amphibians, and insects. But these are not part of the wildlife picture index calculations, so we place a lesser emphasis on them. With that out of the way, let's talk about mammals. To help you identify mammals, we have an interactive Marin Wildlife Watch ID guide. In this tutorial, I'll cover how to use this guide and go through some of the key characteristics to identify the mammals you'll see on camera. We also have a quick reference guide with common names, and you can find all of these materials on the OneTAM website. The mammal guide is set up by species, and you can browse it quickly by looking through the table of contents. In each species page, you can find the common and scientific name, information about size and the short description, and a photo of the animal. Key features give you some of the most important info for ID from photos, with some examples provided. Key features include overall size, proportion of the limbs and tail relative to the rest of the body, color, markings, and behavior. The Don't Confuse With section compares the species to others that may look similar in photos. Individuals of a species will look different depending on their age, habitat type, season, time of day, and lighting. These photo stacks give you examples from actual camera trap images in the project so you can train your eye. You can click on images to make them larger and easier to view. The guide also has an accessibility view, and you can export it as a Word or PDF document if that is something you prefer. Let's start with the mammal we see most often on camera, the mule deer. Mule deer are some of the largest animals you will see. Their coats are not very fluffy, they're grayish brown. Sometimes you'll just see a thin leg or the part of the back or part of an ear up close. Mule deer eat plants, so they tend to hang out in the same spot for a while. This triggers the camera many times, and we can get hundreds of photos of the same deer. Gray foxes are related to dogs. They have black around the snout, and the body's mostly gray with reddish marks around the ears and legs. The tail is very important for ID. The tail is about the same size as the body, with a black stripe and a black tip. Unlike other dogs, gray foxes tend to climb trees. It's easy to confuse gray foxes and coyotes. Compared to coyotes, foxes have shorter legs, smaller, rounder ears, and a longer tail. They're also just smaller. You can see them side by side here. Gray foxes and raccoons can also be confused from some angles. In general, foxes are more svelte than raccoons. Coyotes are also related to dogs. They're about the size of a smaller golden retriever. The body is gray or brownish with some reddish marking. The underbelly is white, and they tend to have a pale sort of smile. They can be confused with gray foxes, but you can tell them apart by looking at the overall body size. Coyotes are typically larger. Coyote legs are longer in proportion to the body, while the gray fox has stubby, shorter legs. Coyote ears tend to be larger and pointier, and coyote tails are a bit shorter. Pumas are not very often seen in Marin, so when you see one, it's very exciting. They're big and overall tan with a light-colored chin and belly. Their tail is long and not very fluffy with a black tip. Pumas can be easily confused with their more common relative, bobcat. Bobcats are much smaller than pumas. Pumas and bobcats have similar colors, but bobcats have spots and stripes on the legs, whereas pumas are just sort of one color overall. Bobcats have a very short tail compared to pumas, foxes, and coyotes. A distinct marking of bobcats is these white markings on the back of the black ears. It's easy to get bobcats confused with house cats. They can be a similar size, but bobcats have that shorter tail. Domestic cats have more variation in overall color and pattern compared to bobcats. Let's talk about skunks now. Skunks are smaller than a house cat, but a little bigger than a kitten. You've probably seen the more common striped skunk with its long tail and white stripes and a black body. But you've probably never seen the western spotted skunk. It's quite elusive and seldom seen without camera traps. The western spotted skunk is smaller than the striped skunk, and instead of stripes, it has splotches. Let's talk about another striped animal, the raccoon. Raccoons are very distinctive with their face mask and striped tail. And they're relatively large in size, the size of a small dog or a large cat. Raccoons tend to get very close to the camera, so sometimes you will only see a part of the face or a paw. From behind, their shape, color, and fur can look a lot like the gray fox. Raccoons are generally broader and rounder than gray foxes. Opossums and raccoons look somewhat similar in terms of body size, color, and some habitat and behavior patterns. Both raccoons and opossums tend to be active at night and can do well near humans. Opossums have a triangular head with a pink snout and a naked, rat-like tail. Let's talk about squirrels. The western gray squirrel is native to Marin. It's about the size of a large rat and has gray fur with a white underside. Its tail is very bushy. The other squirrel you'll see also lives in trees and is introduced. It's more commonly associated with human habitats. The fox squirrel is reddish-brown with a yellow to reddish underbelly. The tail is also bushy, but a bit less so than the gray squirrels. Rabbits are easy to tell apart with their unique long ears and tiny tails. There are two types in Marin, brush rabbits and jackrabbits. Let's do a quick comparison. Brush rabbits are smaller and more compact with beady black eyes. Jackrabbits are larger and have very long ears and very robust back legs. Their eyes are huge with a white ring around them. Onward to small animals that dart around. The camera traps miss some of the smallest animals in this area, things like shrews and moles. The animals we're about to discuss are on the lower size limit of camera detection. Let's start with the dusky-footed wood rat. These are relatively large, about the size of a city rat. You can tell them apart by their very round ears, round body, and long tail. They tend to collect twigs and vegetation to build their nests. Cameras near wood rat nests will take hundreds of photos of them, usually at night, as the wood rats go back and forth collecting nest materials. Wood rats are also social, so you may see more than one hanging out in the same camera. Please classify any other rodent that is not a dusky-footed wood rat as Chrysitidae. This category includes mice and other animals that are hard to tell apart from photos. Chrysitidae are usually active at night, and they are smaller than wood rats, have tiny eyes, and a shorter tail. The other small animal you'll see is the Sonoma chipmunk. This is a small relative of the squirrels. It has black and white stripes on the back and a shorter furry tail. Sometimes they blend in with the leaf litter and they tend to go back and forth collecting food and material for their nests. It's roughly the same size as a wood rat, but you can tell it apart by its color and pattern, by its habits. Wood rats are mostly active at night, while chipmunks are mostly active during the day. Let's move on to long-bodied mammals that travel low to the ground and eat meat. The North American river otter, badger, and weasel are all relatives. The North American river otter is the largest of the three, about the size of a small dog. River otters have a long body with a tail that tapers and a wide head with small ears. They are aquatic and can be seen traveling between water bodies, often in groups. Badgers are smaller than river otters and are more compact in shape and have shorter tails. They live in grassy areas where they hunt and burrow. They have a face that is a bit similar to a raccoon, but the white and black stripes run in a different direction. Their tails are also much shorter and don't have rings. Lastly, there's the long-tailed weasel, the smallest and rarest of this bunch. The weasel is about the size of a pet ferret, but has reddish-brown fur. The tail is long with a black tip, and the face is a unique white patch between the eyes, just above the nose. Weasels are very active and climb all over the place. Black bears are hard to miss. They have been spotted a few times in Marin County, and you'll know when you see one. They are large, dark colored, and have a short tail. Camera traps are not the best way to study bats, but bats do show up from time to time. Bats on camera look like a surreal squiggle or a flying paper towel. OneTam does have a whole project that studies bats, but unfortunately it is not open to volunteers. Watch the other tutorials to learn more about what to do when you see domestic animals and other animals that are not in this guide, including humans.